Alright, in calculus, radian measure is very important, and these values often appear, okay, when you proceed to calculus. So you have to really know the conversion between degrees and radians, okay? So I have here, I hope you see this, angles in degrees are in green, and the angles in radians are given in purple, okay? So let me just kind of walk you through how to do this chart. All right, so hopefully all of you are familiar with degrees by now. Okay, so the quadrantal angles are 0 degrees, 90 degrees, 180 degrees, 270 degrees, and then of course you go back to 360 degrees at the 0 degree mark, right? Okay, and you know that of course to get these other ones, so let's say the 30 degree angle, you kind of like split the first quadrant angle into three, right? Of course, it's hard to make it even, all right? So this is your 30 degree angle, your 60 degree angle, your 45 degree angle bisects the first quadrant angle, okay? And basically, all I did was to get the other multiples in the other quadrants. Of course, I don't have a straight edge, but like if I want the multiple of the 45 degree angle in the third quadrant, I just had to draw the line that goes straight there, okay? Through the origin and hits this, okay? So actually, let me explain that. So the multiple of 45 degrees in the third quadrant is 225 degrees. And how did I get 225 degrees? Remember, reference angle, all I did to get 225 was to add 45 to 180, okay? So again, the way I got 225 degrees was to add the reference angle 45 to 180, so that's 225 degrees, okay? So likewise, as I was drawing the 30 degree angle, I already did it right there to hit the third quadrant multiple. And to get the third quadrant multiple of 30 degrees, all I did was to add 30 to 180, and that's how I got 210 degrees, okay? So for 60, I just drew it again straight off up to there, okay? And so this is 60 degree angle. To get the multiple in the third quadrant, I have 180 plus 60 is 240 degrees. So that took care of two quadrants, the first and the third, okay? Now for the second quadrant angles, again, I'm just talking degrees first, okay? So let's see. So again, it's the same story pretty much, okay? I need these three special angles in the second quadrant, okay? So I need the 30 degree angle, and again, you can just use the reference angle. So if this is 30, measure off 30 degrees here, and I see it's really not accurate, okay? But this is a 30 degree angle, a 45 degree angle, a 60 degree angle measured in the second quadrant, okay? Now, of course, these angles will be called 30, 45, and 60. So now to get this angle that is a multiple of the 30 degree angle in the second quadrant, now you do, what you do is, you have 180, you take away 30, okay? So again, to get the angle in the second quadrant, you get 180, take away 30, that's the 150 degree angle, okay? To get the multiple of the 45 degree angle in the second quadrant, you perform the subtraction, 180 minus 45, so you get 135 degrees. And likewise, to get the multiple in the second quadrant, you get 180 minus 60, that's the multiple of 60 degrees in the second quadrant, that's 120 degrees, okay? So I hope you got that. And then again, the same story, what I did was I just kind of extended the 150 degree angle over here to get all the other multiples in the fourth quadrant. So I drew this line straight like that, then this one like this to get the multiple of pi over 4 in the fourth, and so on and so forth. So now let's see how we can label these angles, okay? So this one is a multiple of pi of 30 degrees, right? Okay, in the fourth quadrant. So notice that's 330 degrees, and really all I did was to subtract, okay, 360 minus 30. So take away the reference angle 30 degrees from 360 degrees, so you have 330 degrees, okay? And then this, if you notice, is a multiple of the 45 degree angle. So this is 360 minus 45. That's how I got 315 degrees. And so on and so forth. So the multiple of 60 degrees, I know this is that multiple of 60 degrees in the fourth quadrant is 360 minus 60. So that's what how I got 300 degrees. So that's the story of the degrees, okay? So let's look at the pi's, the radian measures. So notice here that 0 degrees is exactly the same as 0 radian, right? Okay? And then I explained this earlier that, of course, around is 2 pi, right? So when you go around, you end at the 0 degree mark and that's your 360 degrees first round, okay? And that's now 2 pi. And you can now think differently here. So halfway is pi because half of 2 pi is pi, right? Okay? Between 0 and pi, halfway is pi over 2, correct? And I explained between pi and 2 pi, the halfway mark is 3 pi over 2, okay? And so note it corresponds to these quadrantal angles over here, all right? Now, personally, when I think of like pi over 6, pi over 4, pi over 3, I imagine this upper portion, 0 to pi, as being divided into these pieces that I'm talking about. So when I think of pi over 6, I visualize I'm dividing the top portion into 6. So let's see. So like when I want to draw a pi over 6 angle, that's what I do. And I say I have like 6 pieces. Okay? So I have 6 like this. Did I do it 6? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And there's my pi over 6, okay? A sixth of pi, all right? So that's what I do. And then, of course, the multiple of pi over 6 in the second quadrant is 5 pi over 6. I count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, okay? I mean, something like that is what you can do. So that's your pi over 6. When I want to draw, let's say, pi over 4, I know I need to split the part, the top portion, likewise for the bottom, but I just start here usually. So I say I need 4 pieces. So this is pi over 4, okay? The multiple in the second quadrant is going to be 1, 2, 3, 3 pi over 4, okay? Or if you don't want to count, okay, so here, let's go back here. If it's pi over 6 in the first quadrant, if you don't like to count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, it's not hard really, okay? What you can do is you can also perform what I was talking about with degrees. You can subtract pi minus pi over 6. Do a subtraction. Pi minus pi over 6. I don't know if you prefer fractions like this. And that should give you the same answer. 5 pi over 6. Okay? So likewise here, you can do the perform the operation pi minus pi over 4. That should give you 3 pi over 4 as well. Okay? So let's continue with this story for the other quadrants. So let's say you want to do your multiples of pi over 3. Let's do the complete circle. So I know that I have to split, let's say, that's how I start thinking. I said if it's pi over 3, I have to have 3 pieces. 1, 2, 3. All right? And of course, then you have to do the same thing down here. Alright, so this is your pi over 3, which is your 60 degree angle, okay? So counting, that's 2 pi over 3. Again, you can get the same answer, 2 pi over 3, by performing the subtraction, pi minus pi over 3, to be consistent with how we use our reference angles, okay? Here you can get the multiple of pi over 3 by counting 1, 2, 3, 4, right? So that is 4 pi over 3. Which, if you notice, is consistent with our reference angle method of finding the angle in the next quadrant. And this is, since this is in the third quadrant, this is the same as pi plus pi over 3. Okay? If you want the multiple in the fourth quadrant, you can count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay? So there's my, so if you notice, that's my answer here, 5 pi over 3. Okay? 5 pi over 3. Again, another way of thinking of this, instead of counting, is you can say, well, consistent with how we do reference angles, it's 2 pi minus pi over 3. Hopefully, You see that when you do the arithmetic here, right, do your fraction. So you get 6 pi minus pi is 5 pi over 3, okay? So that's basically how you do it. So really, what is important really is just to know the first quadrant, and you can go from there. In other words, just to remind you what I'm talking about here, this is the main story here. If you have an angle theta over here, the multiple of that angle theta, let me put theta here, okay? This is your theta, your angle theta. The multiple of theta in the second quadrant is what? It's pi minus theta, all right? So whether you're, if you want degrees, sorry, I was going to say whether you do degrees or, it's the same story, right? It's not 90, 180 minus theta. So if this is theta, if you want the multiple in the second quadrant of that angle theta, you can, if you want degree multiple, it's 180 degrees minus theta. If you want the radian multiple, if this is in radians, it's pi minus theta, okay? Now, if you want the third quadrant multiple, it's either in radian, it's pi plus theta, or if you want degrees, it's 180 degrees plus theta. Okay. Yeah, I guess on Sunday I have airplanes, or Fridays I have garbage trucks, okay, and Sundays I have airplanes plus the birds, okay. And then in the fourth quadrant, the multiples are what? So over here, you subtract theta from 360, so it's 360 degrees minus theta, or you can say it's 2 pi minus theta. So in other words, if you know 0, 30, 45, 60, 90, or 0, pi over 6, pi over 4, pi over 3, and pi over 2, you can easily generate these. You don't really have to memorize all these conversions if you know how to get the multiples in the other quadrant using this chart with your reference angle theta, okay? I hope that's clear. And of course, it works not just for special values, but a lot of times in calculus, you will be dealing with these numbers, pi over 4, pi over 6, pi over 3. But this chart works for whatever kind of angle you have, okay? So I hope that helps. So that's how you get your, the conversion, degrees and radians, where to find them, how to find them, how to know that they are the multiple there, okay, and so on and so forth. Okay.